Let's do a more challenging dimensional analysis problem. See, we're traveling a certain speed. We do it in a certain amount of time. And we want to know how far we travel. Maybe you recognize this. Maybe you can pull a formula out of this. Okay, meters, how far? That's distance. The speed is the rate. And the 37 minutes, well, that's the time. Distance equals rate times time. And you solve for distance. Piece of cake, right? Eh, there are some problems. Look at the units. The problem was written in miles per hour, but you want meters. Well, that's also, the speed is miles per hour, and you're given time in minutes. Well, you could do some conversions ahead of time, and then you could solve for distance, but I'm not going to do it that way. I'm going to show you how to do this problem using the dimensional analysis skills we've been working on. Now, I'll admit, when I wrote this problem, I deliberately messed with it. I mean, why ask for meters if it's miles per hour? Because I want to. If you can solve this problem, that means you have a very strong grasp of how to do the dimensional analysis, because this goes back to the earlier problems we did, the relatively simple one-step problems. That's what this is. This is a series of single-step problems. But can you put it together? If you can put this one together properly and understand the pieces, you're ready for more complicated calculations in chemistry. Well, we've got some information here. Let's start pulling it out. See if we can piece it together. Our speed. Well, that's what that means. Miles/hours means if I travel for 1 hour, you expect to go 75.0 miles. When you work problems with combination units like this, do not do the work like this. In my experience, students don't work the problems properly when they do it like that. It's too easy to make mistakes. It's too easy to get confused between your numerator and denominator. So split it apart the way I have. 75.0 miles equals 1 hour. Let me see. Minutes and hours. Okay, we need that relationship. And we need something to go from meters to miles. I can't think of one right off the top of my head. If you look at the conversion sheet that I provide students, do you have one on there that will go directly from miles to meters? Oh, you don't on there, do you? What do you have? What do you have one that bridges between the imperial system, miles, to the metric system? Yeah, I put this one on there. 1 mile equals 1.609 kilometers. And let me see. Oh, we still have one more problem. We're asked for the different distance in meters, but we don't have any meters up there anywhere. We have kilometers. So we need the relationship between kilometers and meters. Kilo equals 1,000. Well, I think we're ready to put this together, but boy, that's a lot of information. What do we do with it? What did the question ask for? It asks for a distance. Now, there are a few ways to start this problem, and when we're done with this problem, I'll, at the very end, I'll show you another way to assemble it. But since I want a distance, a common problem-solving technique is to take a piece of information that you're given and start with that. And we were given the speed. And the speed is 75.0 miles per 1 hour, equal to 1 hour. Okay, well, we can start conversions one of two ways. We can write it this way, or we can take the reciprocal, depending upon the information that's given. And let me remind you of what it means, that piece that I just put down there. That means they're equivalent to each other. Now, obviously, miles and hours aren't equal to each other in that sense. You have a distance and you have a time. No, it's an equivalency, and it's because of our speed that makes them equivalent to each other. If you drive for 1 hour, you expect to go 75.0 miles. And we can also take the reciprocal of conversions. Just, what do the units tell us? Well, which one, this one or the previous one? How do you want to start? Ask yourself, where do you want distance units when you're done? In the numerator or the denominator? If somebody asks you how tall you are, you're not going to tell them you're so many 1 over feet or reciprocal feet. You're going to say you're so many feet or so many meters, something like that. Therefore, we need our distance unit in the numerator. Okay, now I don't like miles, I don't like hours. I'm going to start working on the miles first. You can start working on the hours first, but I choose to start working on the miles first. And I look at the conversions that I wrote down, and I see I have one that relates miles and kilometers to each other. So when I put that conversion down, am I going to go miles over kilometers or kilometers over miles? Kilometers over miles, because allows my miles to cancel. So now I have kilometers per hour. Well, I don't want kilometers. I want meters. So I see another conversion that relates kilometers and meters to each other. So am I going to go kilometers over meters or meters over kilometers in my conversion? Meters over kilometers, for the same reason as before. This allows the kilometers to cancel. So now I have units of meters per hour. I like the meters. Hours, not so much. So let's work on the hours now. Am I going to go hours over minutes or minutes over hours? Hours over minutes allows my hours to cancel. Now I have, unit-wise, let's see. I have meters per minute. There, we're done, because we have meters. No, we want meters, not meters per minute. What do I have left? I didn't pull something out, did I? I still have 37 minutes. So am I going to multiply or divide by the 37 minutes? Well, you're going to multiply. So your minutes units will cancel. And now I have meters in the numerator, nothing else left. That's what I want. Do my multiplication, my division. And the calculator spits this out. Now we have to write the answer according to the proper number of significant figures. So let's go back and look at all the pieces. Starting on the far left with my speed. How many significant figures are in that? Ignore the one. Whenever you have one equals something else, you ignore the one. All the significant figures have been sucked into the other piece. Three significant figures. How about the 1.609? Does the conversion on the sheet say that it's exact? It does not, does it? Therefore, this has four significant figures. Now be careful on your conversion choice. Since I provide a conversion sheet to my students, you would not use 1.6 kilometers as equivalent to 1 mile. Because if you use that one only has two significant figures. The one I provide has four. Next piece. 1,000 meters in a kilometer. Well, 1,000 has one significant figure in it. Therefore, that relationship is, it's exact. It's a metric relationship. Kilo is 1,000, exactly. How many significant figures here? Well, that's another exact relationship. Let's see, you count minutes, right? I count the minutes until I see you again. So that's exact. No, it's not. It's two significant figures. You don't count minutes that way. I know, people say, well, I'm counting the minutes. You're not really. You're measuring the minutes. You're using something that measures minutes. You can't count minutes like they're pencils. So our answer, we only get two significant figures in our answer. So we could write it this way. No decimal place. Remember, you count left to right. We could put it in scientific notation. Either of those bottom two would be correct. There are multiple ways to work this problem. And I don't mean whether or not you use parentheses. What I mean is the order that you place them. This is a little crowded, I realize that. I'm sorry about that. But that setup on the bottom is also legitimate. In this case, which makes the most sense to you? Heck, you could have even started with time. Remember, your dimensional analysis will help you. If you don't end up with units of meters, you know you did not set it up properly. Use that to help you.